All right, let's look at an example where we might use what we know about right triangle trig in order to calculate the cosine of 2 theta and the sine of 2 theta. All right, so if cosine of theta is equal to 6/7 and theta is between 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi, what is the cosine of 2 theta and what is the sine of 2 theta? Well, let's first draw what we think is happening. So if theta is between 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi, that means it sits in the fourth quadrant. So if I were to sketch that, that means that I'm over here, right? Okay, so if cosine of theta is equal to 6/7, that means I could draw this right triangle here, which is certainly not to scale. So my x-axis, or my the base of my triangle is 6 and the hypotenuse is 7. We can use the Pythagorean theorem to find this leg. So I know that 7 squared is equal to 6 squared plus, we'll say, y squared. So we'll call that piece y. So 49 equals 36 minus y squared. Oops, plus y squared. And 49 minus 36 is equal to y squared. So I have 13 is y squared. And this tells me that y is plus or minus the square root of 13. And since I'm in the fourth quadrant, I know my y is negative. So here I have y equals negative square roots of 13. Okay, so this is useful because it tells me, scroll this down, how I'm going to, I'm going to use my formulas for cosine of 2 theta and sine 2 theta, and I need to know sine of theta. So here, I get the sine of theta is equal to negative square roots of 13 over 7, and I was given that the cosine of theta is equal to 6/7. All right, so A was to find the cosine of 2 theta. So at this case, I need to plug in one of my formulas for cosine of 2 theta. So remember, one of them was 2 cosine squared of theta minus 1. All right, so that means 2 times 6/7 squared minus 1, or 2 times 36/49 minus 1, or, just running out of room, let's come up here, 72/49 minus 1. So I can rewrite 1 as 49/49, and if I subtract 49 from 72, I get 23/49. So the cosine of 2 theta in this case is 23/49. All right, what about the sine of 2 theta? So the sine of 2 theta, I want to now use my formula for the double angle for sine, is equal to 2 sine theta cosine theta. Okay, let's move this away so we don't get it confused. So I have both of these because I used my right triangle information up here. It's equal to 2 times the negative square root of 13/7 times 6/7. And that's equal to negative 12 square roots of 13 all over 49. There is the sine of 2 theta.